Pfizer says its COVID-19 vaccine works on UK and South African variants. The COVID-19 virus has two variants that concern health experts worldwide. When the UK variant spread, many asked if COVID-19 vaccines would still work. That question referred to the vaccine's efficacy against the UK and South African variants. Pfizer responded to the question and conducted tests of its vaccine versus the variants. On January 8, Pfizer announced the results of their tests. They revealed that in vitro study of the Pfizer-BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine neutralized a key mutation in the two variants. Those who received the vaccine should produce antibodies that could neutralize that mutation. They also showed that several mutations were found in the spike or S glycoproteins, which are targeted by antibodies. While the two mutations evolved separately, both shared the N501Y mutation located at the receptor binding site of the spike protein. The mutation allowed the coronavirus variants to bind more tightly to the receptor of human cells. This would make human cells more susceptible to the virus, which investigators determined in the mice models. Investigators tested the efficacy of the vaccine on two variants using the antibodies of 20 participants who joined Phase 3 clinical trials. Antibodies neutralized SARS-CoV-2 with and without the mutation. The results were consistent in 15 pseudoviruses bearing the spikes with other mutations of coronavirus strains. Overall, the mutation offered no resistance against the immune responses elicited by the vaccine. The Pfizer-BioNTech is not approved or licensed by the US FDA as a vaccine for COVID-19. However, it received emergency use authorization to fight the pandemic. The EUA only covers people aged 16 years and older. Its performance in children and younger teens is unknown at this time. Meanwhile, the company reminded the public of the vaccine's prescribing rules. The top rule is it should not be given to anyone with a history of severe allergic reactions, like anaphylaxis, to any component of the vaccine. The rules also included known adverse reactions in clinical studies of participants aged 16 years and older. Pain at the injection site is the most common at 84.1%, followed by fatigue at 62.9% and headache at 55.1%. Other reactions include muscle and joint pain, chills, fever, and general weakness. The tests were conducted by Pfizer and the University of Texas Medical Branch.